I'm Claude Yancey. I am medical director of the Baylor Heart and Vascular Institute in Dallas, Texas at Baylor University Medical Center and within the Baylor Healthcare System, and I'm currently president of the American Heart Association. The study on which I worked is a study that is still ongoing, and it looks at the surgical treatment of persons who have heart disease due to blocked blood vessels. It really is the forebearer for what we call comparative effectiveness research, comparing medical treatments versus surgical treatments. When that answer comes about, it'll be a game changer. It'll make a big difference. But let's consider the implications. Let's think about the crossroads. Certain investigators today are actually re-engineering organs on the bench that potentially can take the place of transplanted organs. Imagine a world where we have virtually unlimited access to organs so that we can proceed with transplantations. But the mechanisms of disease, the basic fundamental understanding that drives everything else, the engine of discovery, needs to be, as it has been, a property of the NIH, which means that we collectively own that. That empowers our society. That gives us the intellectual resource that keeps us in front and provides for our future generations. The only way that we can bring our society forward in any specific area is through the progression of science. And the NIH owns that, needs to continue to own that, and we need to make the investment of time and resources to make that happen. The message today for those that are in control of the NIH budget is simple: get it done. There's no other modifier here. And for future generations, embrace research. Let's say, for example, that we draw back and we say we simply can't afford to invest in research. Do you know what happens? Because I've seen this happen. Talented investigators opt for a different career. Discoveries left on the bench never materialize, never provide help. A cure for a disease may be left on a bench someplace because an investigator didn't have funding to get it done. But the reality is that if we don't make this happen, we lose our traction, we lose our investigators, we lose our intellectual capital, we lose our hope for the future. That's not acceptable.